Welcome to the couch, you guys, where your mental health matters. So can we talk for a bit? We're definitely going to do that, you guys. I'm checking all the angles, checking them all, wherever the light hits.
So we
definitely going to talk for a minute. We're going to talk about an important topic, an exciting topic, an intriguing topic as well.
A training topic.
But again, I'm your host, Dan. I got my co-host, Jaquellen, a.k.a. Dammit Jackie,
a.k.a. Juicy J.
Juicy J is in the building. We here. We appreciate you guys for plugging in with us each and every week. And you know how we do here on the couch. We definitely talk about mental health from our perspective. Of course, we're two both licensed clinicians, so we do this on a daily basis, even when we don't want to. We still do it.
Mostly when we don't want to.
So we're going to bring, you know, we bring an interesting perspective in keeping mental health, you know, raising awareness regarding mental health. But we do it in our own special way. We do it differently. That's one of our hashtags. We do it differently.
Mm. Is that a new hashtag of ours?
We do it differently.
We do it differently.
Yeah. Because we got our colleagues and we got, you know, other shows that are kind of similar to ours. So, but we do it a little bit differently.
Yeah, we have a...
We got a little bit of clatchet going on.
The same
on.
As ours, almost.
A little bit of clatchet.
A little bit of clatchet. Classy and ratchet. Classy.
Are you going to...
Dang, you add the element. Come on. You. I do it by myself. I'm sorry, y'all. Can you let us know who you believe adds the classy element to the show?
I'll wait.
Do, 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 do.
I will wait for that one.
Do, do, do. They ain't saying nothing. There's no bad blood.
And speaking of the topic for today.
Oh, speaking of ratchet...
Ratchet and classy and everything in between. We're gonna talk about some of these narcissists out here.
Okay, here we go.
And this is gonna be. See, look at it. I like that.
She gave a politically correct answer. Yes. It's not both of us. Girl, please.
But you know what you're trying to say, but it's all good.
Yep.
So we're definitely gonna get into that. We're gonna talk about narcissism as it relates to media, social media. What else? Relationships. We're going to try to touch on all of those topics today. It's going to be a pretty cool and exciting topic.
Educational.
Because I think we've all encountered a narcissist, or you may be a narcissist, and you may not even realize it. So we're definitely going to give you some symptoms and some characteristics of some narcissistic behavior. But before we get into that, you guys, each and every week, you know how we do. We do our mental health trending topic of the week. And it's brought to you by, I don't even know what that was. I wanted to do like a ding, ding, ding. I wanted to do some rings or something like that, but it just didn't come out. But our resident Wendy Williams is here in the building. Jackie, a.k.a. Dammit Jackie. So she's going to, we're going to talk about this mental health trending topic.
Yeah.
And we want to get you guys' insight as well. Give me some comments. On IG as well, we talk to you guys. Y'all talk to each other. All those good things. So everything in between. Let's talk about it. What's the topic for today?
Okay, so we're going to talk about Lizzo, right?
Lizzo,
and it was an NBA game, right? Where she had her butt out in her outfit. She had her butt out, and I saw the video that she posted on social media where she was saying, look, this is just me. This is just who I am.
Mm-hmm.
And when I heard them playing this song, I had to get up and dance with the cheerleaders. I was excited. You know, I never changed who I am. But now, a few days later, you're just kind of seeing she's having emotional breakdowns about it, upset about the backlash that she's gotten. And people are very offended that it was a family-oriented environment, meaning that there were children there,
mm-hmm.
And that it was completely indecent.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I've seen and read a lot of different comments, a lot of different perspectives on this topic. I mean, you know what my response is going to be, you know, to generalize it, she can do what the hell she wants. Mm-hmm. However, there are consequences for every action that you do, mm-hmm. whether that be people talk about you or whatever. But, you know, it's a free country. She can wear what she want to wear, whatever the case may be. Now, if she gets cited for indecent exposure or something like that, that's totally on her.
Mm-hmm.
That's her choice. With saying that, I still have an opinion, of course, because mm-hmm. that's what we do. Now, in regards to that, I mean, I understand that she wants to be free and liberated and, you know, represent for the BBWs out there and self-expression, all those things. However, like you said, there's a time and place for everything.
Mm-hmm.
And the NBA game is not one of them. Now, I did see where there were some people comparing that to Nicki Minaj when she was at NBA games. She may have had like something see-through and short.
Mm-hmm.
Or Rihanna when she had like some shorts on, but they were slit all the way up the side, so you mm-hmm. can see like sides. But
this was actually her butt cheeks.
Right? It was her actual butt cheek out. Like,
yeah,
I could see a concert. If it was a concert, cool. That environment may call for that. But not a family friendly, no. Where you know kids are going to be there, and it's that attention seeking, that shock factor that she was out there. And I mean, she got it. However, I mean, positive or negative, she still got the attention.
Yeah, she did.
So it's definitely a marketing ploy to continue her name going, besides the little one hit that she has going on right now.
Well, she was excited. She had a whole hit.
Yeah, so I mean.
And they played it.
And so it inflated her ego.
Yeah, it did.
Which is a part of one of the symptoms and characteristics of the personality disorder mm-hmm. that we're going to be speaking of, inflated self-esteem.
That's right.
One of them. So.
Just one.
So, I mean, like, what was your thoughts, you guys? Do you think, like, it was in bounds for her to do that? She can do what she want, and you thought it was cool? Or what? Like.
My opinion is that there were kids everywhere, and that wasn't the time or the place. There's also laws about indecent exposure,
mm-hmm.
and I say that was indecent. I think showing your actual butt cheek and short shorts are two different things.
Yeah.
It's like exposing, you know, like I said, parts of body that children should not be exposed to.
And I don't object or have preference in regards to body type. So regardless whether she was big or nah, like that still wouldn't be right even if Rihanna did it. You know what I mean? Like, it'll be a pleasure to look at, of course. However, you know, it's time and place for that. Now, Rihanna's concert is totally different.
It's Beyonce's totally different.
Concert is totally different.
Yeah.
You know, she's not probably going to wear a thong performing at the NBA All-Star game. You know what I mean?
Right.
But in her concert, she will definitely do that.
Yep.
So, I mean, what do y'all think?
Not the right time and place.
Not the right time?
Or place.
We got Mike joining. Mike Vroom.
Hey,
what's up, Vroom?
Hey,
Vroom?
Mike. Hey, Vroom.
It's one of our colleagues.
Yeah.
Shout him out. He's a dope therapist
Shout out
as well.
To Mike.
Absolutely.
I haven't seen Mike brothers. In a long time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I haven't talked to him either, but yeah.
We see you
out there. We see you.
All right.
So, again, you guys. Topic for today, narcissism mm-hmm. as it relates to social media, relationships, society in general. Has social media increased the relevance or the you being more prone to being narcissistic?
Okay, does social media increase and enhance narcissistic behaviors?
Yes, absolutely.
On the outside, potentially.
Yeah.
Well, you know what I mean by looking.
Right.
Because you really don't know what people are thinking
exactly.
internally. You can only judge by either they're posting pictures of this or that.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Yeah.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. So let's go ahead and get the topic started. Mm-hmm. So the first and foremost, what we want to do is identify, for those that don't know IG World, Facebook, on the platform, what it means to be narcissistic
mm-hmm.
or what characteristics are shown as a person who exhibits narcissistic behavior.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to list some of those things. And if you can check off some of those boxes, you might be a narcissist.
Very easily.
Hey, the first step is acceptance.
Thank you, counselor. The first step is acceptance.
Yes, absolutely. So Jackie, tell me, like, what are like some of the symptoms or the characteristics that you've seen or that you've experienced or that you know that is congruent with a narcissist?
Okay, so I would say an inflated idea of self-confidence, like inflated, mm-hmm. right? Like they know they're good at something, but they always feel like they're good at everything.
Right.
I find that it's hard for a narcissist to admit to being wrong about things. It's hard for them to admit to being wrong because they usually view themselves as right and other people as wrong.
Right.
Mm-hmm. I guess I would also say that... Okay, so you're saying the character... You're talking about characteristics that they show, not mm-hmm. things that we should... Well...
I mean, that's both. Like, you would look out for them, but just characteristics or symptoms, signs that you may be dealing with a narcissist.
Well, they tend to have their own stories concocted for most things, right? Where they try to get other people on board to go along with what they're thinking and their idea, their fantasy creation of what's actually happening.
Right.
And when you don't get on board with them, you like become their enemy, right?
Mm.
And they try to get people around you to agree with them,
right?
To see it their way, and they just wind up bringing on more details of a fantasy that kind of makes you look at them twice, kind of like, are they serious what they're saying?
Right.
Yes, they are. They believe what they're saying. They believe you're wrong and they're right, and it's hard for them to be empathic for other people. Okay.
Not being an empath is one of those.
It's hard for them to be empathic.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And to empathize with,
is it empathic or empathetic?
Empathic.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Learn something.
Not empathetic.
It's not empathetic?
I know some therapist on our fee is going to correct us.
Okay.
Okay, we're open
please,
to it.
Please correct
us. Make us better.
Is it empathetic or empathic?
You know I'm about to look it up right now. I can't
We don't have time for you to look it up. How would you know?
You had time for me to look on for the butterfly on Amazon.
It's EM, right?
Empathic.
You put EP.
Empathic is what? Don't tell people that I speak. Yo, why you gotta tell people I speak?
Yo, I did not put you on blast.
Okay. All right.
I didn't. All right. My apologies if you felt that way.
Not,
it wasn't
I'm
my
fine.
Intent.
Okay. Showing an ability to understand and share the feelings of another.
Right.
People who have narcissistic behaviors do not do that very well. They're not showing empath.
Right.
Wait, they're not showing empathic signs of empathy.
You got it.
They're not showing signs of empathy. Oh my God, do we have master's degrees?
I know, right? Like
sometimes I feel like...
You would think like we would...
Where did it go?
Like... We haven't studied and did a whole bunch of papers and everything else.
For sure.
With sometimes how we mess up in our vernacular.
But yeah, they don't like to be corrected.
Right.
They don't like to be corrected. They don't like to be wrong. And they are not empathic.
Like that word, not empathic.
Okay, I've said
it. She loves it, you guys.
All right. So
one, they have a huge sense of entitlement.
Yes.
Elevated self-esteem.
Arrogance.
It's kind of a huge arrogance to the point to where they feel like they can't do any wrong. And it's the world that's out. They live in this bubble, this mental bubble, and everybody else is revolving around them. Like, they're the sun, and people are just planets. They're just around them. They can't be in the same space.
You know what else they say about them? That they may complain a lot about rudeness or people being clumsy around them or making mistakes. And when you said, is there anything in my personal history that I remember, it's going to a restaurant with a narcissist, with somebody who is basically a narcissistic personality.
Right.
And complaining that the waiter, not just complaining, but then switching waiters. We got to switch waiters. No, we're going to switch waiters. This is what we're going to do.
Wow.
Waiter switch. Didn't like where we were sitting.
Yeah.
I don't like where we sitting. Then we gotta move. Wait, are you serious? We gotta move. We just ordered. Yeah.
So,
They're unhappy with everything.
So take down some of these notes, you guys. For sure. I'm pretty sure you've encountered it.
Oh, yeah.
Or you've done it yourself. So let's do some self-reflection here. Be honest with ourselves on some of these things. One of the big ones that I read was having the inability or unwillingness to recognize the needs of others.
Unwillingness to recognize the needs of others.
Right. Or the feelings.
Their needs overshadow.
Yes.
All of the needs of others.
Right.
Okay.
They don't think about how someone else will feel
mm-hmm.
in that particular situation. They're just more concerned with how they feel. And that's it.
And their grandiose sense of self.
Right.
Yeah.
Come across like we said, arrogant. Insist on having the best of everything, whether that's house, car, all of those things. You can be in huge debt, but you still buy these things because you enjoy the attention or the perspective that it brings, or the notoriety that it brings to you
in
achieving those things.
So they also said that, and from experience, you know, if you think about it, a lot of people with narcissistic personality disorder have short-term relationships because they're not paying attention to the needs mm-hmm. of the spouse or the mm-hmm. person that they're with enough.
And they seek out a certain type of individual to be in a relationship with because they almost feel needed. They want to feel needed. Narcissistic people want to feel needed. And when they don't feel that, then it's everybody else's issue.
Okay. Should I?
They suck.
Are we sticking to the script or can I?
No, we're going to stick to the script. We're going to get to that, though.
I have something to say about it.
We're going to get to that, though. I mean, you can go ahead, though.
Okay.
Go ahead.
With that part.
Because it's burning up inside.
It is a little bit.
I feel the energy right now. I feel the burning.
I have something to say.
I feel the heat.
This makes it worse. Let me just say this. They can hear mm-hmm. what you're saying. And they'll nod their head, and it's almost part of their nature just to say, okay, mm-hmm. And then within, it's not even like 24, 48 hours later that you see it didn't really go anywhere. They didn't right. do anything with it.
Right.
And I have to say that I've been more of an empath. So I've mm-hmm. learned that about myself, and I've learned to control
yeah.
a lot of my my grandiose need to be that way, mm-hmm. right? Yeah. Hovering and taking care of other people and their right. feelings all the time where yeah. I neglect my own.
Absolutely.
That narcissists feed on that. So they right. like that attention. And I'm somebody who likes communication. So mm-hmm. narcissists don't like to be ignored. So mm. when they pull back, I wasn't paying attention to them pulling back.
Right.
And then what I was giving them.
Right.
But I was giving them too much to feed off of.
Mm.
So I'm being aware of that.
And just sucked all the energy out of you. Yeah. Everything that you wanted to give plus more. The things that you didn't necessarily want to give.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But they also have this sense of like they're superior. They're better than everyone else without the necessary achievements that warrant it.
And their spouses too.
So it's kind of like those people that you see on social media that don't really know. Yeah, they're not doing anything, but they're like this
talking
life coach, and they want to coach you and stuff and shit that they haven't experienced.
They're like, not doing anything, but they're a life coach. Who are you coaching?
And because they have this personality, because narcissism,
yeah,
it can project almost in a positive manner, like you have this spirit, mm-hmm. you know what I mean? Like you're inviting and you like the life of the party. Most of the time, so it comes off as you being genuine and you want to help these people and you want to do all these things, but internally it's feeding into your ego that
yeah.
they want you and they're hearing you and they're
right.
replying to you in awe, like, oh my goodness, thank you, you know,
mm-hmm.
that type of
yeah.
thing. So the gratification that you're getting from doing these things is not in genuine, like, oh, I'm humbled. It's just like, you know, feed me, see more, like I need more type thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So that was just my spiel. My little thing.
They say.
Who is they?
I'm sorry. I know. They say. Who the hell is they? I don't know if these are facts, but this looks good to me. They said that.
What did it say?
People with narcissistic personality disorder in relationships may plaster your Facebook page with comments and flattery in order to gauge your attention.
Mm-hmm.
And to pull you in. And they also
yeah.
use sex as tools for manipulation.
Yeah.
Yet, listen.
I swear.
If he's talking about what he can do in the bedroom all the time, he could be doing it. But I'm saying if he's talking about it all the time,
right.
he's trying to pull your attention his direction. And manipulate you with
things.
That.
And right. manipulate
you with that.
Yeah.
And so they're saying people who are quick to also pull you into a relationship.
Mm.
And I've seen that firsthand in my own life, and I recognized it.
Right.
You know,
right.
somebody who was very quick to pull me through it. You
mm-hmm.
know, like, hey, let's just bag this up right here.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Let's do it. After
that's what they
weeks,
want.
Let's get that commitment going.
Don't air
what are you
my
trying
dirty
to do?
Laundry.
You just
it's,
aired your dirty laundry by
Jack.
Saying that.
You know I can't.
I wasn't talking
pass.
About you, Jackie.
I don't know if you guys have a relationship
after 2 weeks.
Yeah, I have. Yeah.
Well, I appreciate your truth. I appreciate that.
Oh, yeah, I have. Because I'm an empath. Somebody catered to
uh-huh.
my emotional need at the time.
Right.
And I was like, okay, I don't need to date several people. I
mm-hmm.
will go with this. And I remember I said on another show that I have gotten to know people.
Right.
After saying, all right, I'm committed to this and getting to know you, committed to getting to know a person moving forward and
okay.
not getting to know several people at the same time.
Mm.
A lot of people are
yeah,
like
that.
Yeah,
we did talk about that
yeah.
as far
mm-hmm.
as dating.
Yeah. So go ahead.
All that stuff. Anything else? There's a list.
There's so much.
There's so much. There's a lot of research that's been done on narcissistic personality disorder. You know, you can talk about, you know, how it affects you in relationships. All of those things, just your interpersonal skills or inability or abilities. Because, I mean, there are some positive things about being narcissistic.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what they are, but it just sounded good for me to say that just now. But one of the big ones, though, did I scare you?
Yeah. you don't usually touch me while you're done.
But one of the biggest ones is that a narcissist will like to monopolize conversations. They'll talk over you.
Control them.
They'll control the conversation, mm-hmm. control the narrative. If it's not something that they necessarily want to talk about, they're going to turn the attention to them and what they want to talk about.
Look at this. Can you have narcissistic behavior, but you're a total introvert? I would say yes. You can have narcissistic behavior, but be an introvert, because you can still think these things, have this thought process of I am grandiose, I am bigger and better, but you don't have to be front and center.
You can be at home in your own house thinking that
you're bigger and better than everybody else.
When you look in the mirror, you're like, damn, that's a sexy mofo right there. But when you go out, you kind of like, you just chill and lay back in the cut and not really provoke conversations.
I'm giving the lay back in the cut face.
Nah, you just go back there and, you know, hold up the wall type thing.
What did Kevin Hart say? Did he say, this is how you post up? He said something like, this is how you rep a block. He said, this is how I'm going to rep the block real quick. I'm going to rep this block.
Oh my gosh. Right.
I'm just going to post up.
You're just going to post up. You know what I'm saying? And actually, the narcissistic behavior or the mentality that you do have with just posting up is going to say that the women are going to come to you.
Right.
You don't have to go to them.
Because they'll be attracted to
that. They're going
to
be attracted to your vibe, quote unquote, and you don't have to do a lot of work. You don't have to go up and try to initiate conversations because they're going to come to you. So I do like that question. That's a really good question.
It's a good question. They also crave for the best of everything. They also crave for the best in everything. And they, you said what?
We said that earlier. I think so. But go ahead.
I didn't hear you say that.
Yeah, we said the best of everything. Houses, cars, money.
I didn't hear you say that, dear. Yeah, okay,
absolutely.
Keep going.
But they also look down on people as far as their perspective.
Yes, they do.
And thinking that they're wrong and they're right. So it's
always.
That's really aggravating to not, you know, be able to feel like your points and your perspective is validated as much as theirs. You know, everybody has an opinion, you know, and it's, you know, whatever.
I think beneath the surface, it'll always come out that they believe their way is better, and then you'll start to see the patterns.
Mm.
You know, you'll start to recognize. Because in my own experience, now that I'm thinking, their way was always better. I hear you. I hear you. But I'm going to go with my instinct on this.
Right, right.
I'm going to go with my instinct, because that's superior. Yeah?
Mm. Mm-hmm. It, but it's a lot, you guys. And make sure, like, if you want to know more, because we can't go on an entire list, entire checklist of, you know, what it is to be a narcissist or the symptoms. I mean, I can just sum it up in one word, really. Trump.
Okay.
So if you know who Donald Trump is and see how he moves and shakes, how he communicates, how he acts, he's probably the poster boy right now for narcissistic personality disorder.
He tries to get people on board with his way of thinking, and then if they're against him in any way, y'all see, he criticizes them, scrutinizes them, tries to have other people looking at them like they don't know what they're talking about.
Mm-hmm.
I also picked up on what causes narcissistic personality disorder.
Right.
And a lot of it has to do, they said, with parenting style.
Mm-hmm.
People that overly pamper their children. Or overly criticize.
And on a previous episode, we were talking about how society has changed to where everybody is like a winner.
Where they're giving out trophies for 20th place.
Yeah, you're getting like the same, you know what I'm saying, recognition as first, and you
guess
came
first
in
place.
For you.
Okay.
So you have like this, that sense of entitlement, like, hey, I participated, so I should get the same thing that the number one guy get. No, you don't get anything.
Okay.
Only winners get wings.
So if you're, Okay. If your kids are competing in a sport and your son's team comes in third place and he's crying, he's upset, are you going to offer to take him to his favorite restaurant after that? Or are you just going to tell him you can't win everything? And are you going to try to console that in some way,
too? You can console that, but he may not... Oh, I mean, of course I'll take him out just for his ability to say, okay, I pushed through even though we lost. I mean, I'm not going to do that, but I'm not going to say, you didn't get a first place trophy, so I'm going to go out and buy you a first place trophy because you're first place in my heart. You're the first
place. No, I'm not going to say that either. I don't say that either.
Right.
Listen, let me
tell you. I wouldn't do that.
Let me tell y'all something. Yesterday, yesterday my son was in karate. And I have tried to pull myself away to have my own personal boundaries, pull myself away from the practice while it's going on, so I come in when it's over now. So I came in the last few minutes. I came in enough time to see my son looking back at me and his head hanging down like this. So he literally would lift it up to look back, and then when he see me, he would do like this. So at some point, I got concerned. I probably shouldn't have done this, but I yelled out, "Hey, what happened?" I thought like some kid bullied him or something. I know, I was starting to wild out a little bit. Wow. So I said, "Hey, what happened?" And he yells from across the mat, "I couldn't break the board." I said, and I'm going to say this is bad probably as a therapist. But I said, "Hey," I didn't say suck it up. But I said, "Hey, you can't do everything right." Just shut up. Finish what you do. I mean, because I know. But
hey, man, you can't
I don't want to invalidate.
Everything.
No, but you can't win everything. And when he got in the car, I said, "Listen, you can have your feelings hurt about it.
Right.
You can feel bad about it. But these kids that are breaking the boards have been here much longer than you, and they've been practicing. And you would rather do other things rather than practice.
Right.
And even though you're here a few days a week, you just started. And so I had to tell him, you are not the best at everything.
Yeah.
You can do puzzles better than all your friends. But karate, you're going to have to work on the chop a little bit more. Because you ain't chopping
the follow through.
The follow through of the chop. Yeah, I'm not telling him anything nuts. Like, he can do everything he wants to do. Or
you get an A for effort.
No. I tell him there's got to be a last
rewards.
Place.
Yes.
Look, somebody.
If you're not first, you're last.
I don't say that. But
said by Ricky Bobby.
Said by Ricky Bobby.
The philosopher.
If you ain't first, you're last.
That's just what it is.
Okay.
But... you know, but again, you guys, make sure you guys are doing your research before you're diving into relationships.
And share this.
Yeah, share
it. Okay, there are narcissists everywhere all over your timeline. You know it.
You know it. And we're going to get to that. We're going
to
talk about social media and narcissism. Let's jump into that right now.
Okay, let's go.
What do you think? I mean, I personally think because social media has become a thing of pictures, you know, Insta famous, like you can become famous overnight just by pictures that you drop. So now you have this inflated ego that these fans are actually fans, or the amount of friends that you have or followers are actually fans of you. So you have this inflated ego. Let's just say like Instagram, you get 2 million followers, you think you're the actual...
I think that's exciting to anybody, but it's when it's how prominent it is on our brain.
Right.
Right?
Right.
So,
I got to post. Yeah. I got to check in. Like, got to let you know where I'm at. Got to let you know what I'm doing.
Mm-hmm.
Let you know what I'm buying today. See what gas I'm buying.
Just the
what I'm reading.
It becomes narcissistic when you convince yourself that people care that much about certain things about you.
Right.
Let me say this. I had a job a few years ago where I was in a car with a supervisor and another employee, and they actually made jokes about how they looked up my Facebook profile. I thought I told you this. No, before I got hired. And one of them actually mentioned how many photos I had of myself in my... Oh, yeah. She was a trip. She counted. It was like over 100.
Right.
And so she said, "Well, you have 100 and something odd photos of yourself on your Facebook page, just selfies. So what does that say?" And I remember my response, and I really took a deep breath before I said it. And I told her, I said, "Well, it's not like you're obligated to really know this, but I went through so many years of my life where I didn't have much self-esteem."
Right.
And when I finally got to a point where I completely accepted who I was, the odd features I felt I had, and things like that. And I got beyond accepting it. I became proud of it. And just complete acceptance of my laugh that annoys people, my big eyes, my big ears.
My eyes, she like sucking in front of me like this.
Yeah, but I'm really, I have owned that completely. Yeah. I know that I have a lot of pictures of myself now. I used to have none. So if you go back years and look at the type of photos I have, mm-hmm. I'm more proud of my abilities right. to be like, hey, no, I throw this out because this is Jackie, right. whether I'm dancing on my Instagram or it's just a photo of me at work, because I really now accept everything. Mm-hmm. But I'm not seeking for 100 likes when I have 10, or it doesn't agitate me,
right.
or I don't feel like I'm that important for people to pay attention to. It's just about like, how I feel.
I only got 5 likes on this, so I'm deleting it.
I'm deleting it.
There's something wrong with that picture.
No, I think people do that.
Yeah, of course they do.
Okay, people do that.
How many mm-hmm. selfies do you take?
Before you get to the right one?
Yeah.
Before I think we've talked about this before.
Yeah.
It only takes me one take. Or two. Some pictures.
Hey, how many pictures do you have in your phone right now?
A lot.
That's like...
A lot of myself.
That you haven't posted.
A lot.
Yeah. Like, is your storage full up? Like,
my storage is not full. Okay. But we're also like now media person. It's gonna be a little different now because we do mostly media stuff.
Right.
Okay. So compare yourself to us.
If there's a purpose behind,
if there's a purpose,
behind what you're doing, of course.
Yeah.
However, if you're just checking in mm-hmm. and you're doing like 5 selfies a day,
checking in at McDonald's, we here.
You know, all of that. So that's. When is too much? Too much. You know what I mean? Like, I understand. Mm-hmm. I think more women post selfies more than guys. I wonder what the number is for that.
I see a lot of men. Let me tell you this one thing. I'm not even attracted to men that I see posting selfies all the time. I just can't do it. I can't. I have just transference. Because to me, it reminds me of signs of a narcissist.
Right.
It reminds me of the beginning signs or mm-hmm. some elementary signs
right.
of narcissistic behavior in right. men. So let's just keep it real. There are certain traits that women are more known for and right. men are more known for.
Right.
Naturally, just human nature and then society mm-hmm. puts those labels on you. But, you know, taking pictures of yourself is not usually labeled a complete mat, right. like a real masculine trait.
Mm-hmm.
Every man has some form, a bit of femininity in him. And every woman has a little bit of masculinity in her.
Right, absolutely.
But for me, it's just too much about themselves.
Mm.
And it makes me feel like they're not really focused on important things.
I think if I see like a lot of selfies, like nobody else in your pictures,
mm-hmm.
that will raise a red flag for me.
Like, who do you, wait, where is everybody? And why don't they want to be around you? Wait, what is Sebastian Maniscalco? He's a comedian. He says he calls them lonelies, not selfies.
Lonelies.
He calls people, he says people taking a lonely. He said, where are the people around you? How come nobody wants to be around you? Why are you always taking your own lonely photo?
Right.
Yeah, he calls them lonelies.
Hmm.
It's very funny to me.
That's
just an interesting concept.
Lonelies.
Lonelies.
Hashtag lonelies.
Hashtag lonelies.
Lonely day.
It's gonna be a lonely day.
So I mean, we talked about Donald Trump, you know, and him fitting the bill for being a narcissist or mm-hmm. exhibiting narcissistic behavior. What are some other celebrities or well-known people that would be considered a narcissist?
So they're saying Madonna, and I looked it up on the internet, and there's a list, okay? This is not like the Journal of Psychology.
Right.
Or anything like that.
Right.
There's the internet,
okay? There's
no
peer-reviewed article.
No, this isn't
right.
a copyrighted article. These aren't real sources, okay?
Right, but they're
sources. They're sources.
Right.
They're ones that we're using for
right.
this show.
Exactly.
The intranet, which has no chill. Says that Lady Gaga
mm-hmm.
is one of them, and so is Madonna. Kanye West, I know you all will jump right behind that because y'all
right.
like to get on my boy, but he does have some inflated, grandiose sense of self.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not even going to get into the types of things he's used as a reference for himself and people.
Right.
And, important.
So, I mean, like, with that, I mean, I didn't want to skip over it, but people who exhibit narcissistic behavior can also have anxiety and depression and mood disorders. So just because somebody's depressed don't mean that they still don't think they the shiznit.
listen, they can be sad and grandiosely self-involved.
Right.
At the same
because
time.
Because they're gonna grab you and be like, look, I'm sad, I'm depressed. Come over here.
Come and help me.
Yeah,
you're
help
an empath.
Me. Yes.
This is what you do.
Exactly.
And you empaths, listen, we need to have accountability for our own behaviors too, right? Mm-hmm. Because empaths feed narcissistic personality disorders. Yeah. We feed them. We pay attention to them. We're like, what's wrong? Are you okay? When they send us the emoji and the text, you know what I'm saying? Like, in order to gauge us, we give in to it at times, right?
Absolutely.
Like, what do you mean? Are you okay? What's going on? They like that attention. Yeah, I used to do that all the time. What does it mean? Why you give the thumbs up and the side eye? What does that mean together?
Right.
We empaths question things because they're a little uneasy about what's really going on because we need answers.
Mm-hmm.
We need verbal communication.
Right.
And narcissistic personality disorder individuals that have that, they know that they will wait longer. They will ignore you, but they don't like to be ignored.
Right.
They will ignore you, but they don't like to be ignored because ignoring you gives them control.
Mm-hmm.
They have the one leg up when they ignore you.
Mm-hmm. And that's a power thing with narcissists.
It's a power thing. And the way you respond to them is crucial.
It's always a power thing, a power struggle.
Yes.
They feel like they don't...
Entitlement.
That sense of entitlement. Like, you owe me.
Mm-hmm.
You owe me everything. You owe me your love.
Mm-hmm.
You owe me your sex. You owe me everything. Because I'm just who I am.
Another thing is they'll try to manipulate situations in the relationship by constantly digging up dirt on you so they can bring it up later.
Ooh.
I've had this happen to me firsthand.
Ooh.
Constant reminders of, remember when you did this, or remember when you said that you were thinking about doing this, and try to find out ways that they can use it against you to make you feel guilty so that you carry this guilt where they have control over you to manipulate you emotionally. Hello, somebody. Y'all quiet today?
Hey.
Y'all are quiet.
They listening.
Y'all on your phones taking notes because this is what
they
do.
Like, let me look this up because
I
think that there's a fine line between having a high self-esteem or a healthy, esteem of yourself and being confident versus being narcissistic.
Yeah.
You know, if you're confident in your abilities, you know, and, you know, you just feel good about yourself. It really doesn't matter. You accept yourself for who you are.
Yeah.
And it is what it is, you know, and you just say take it or leave it type thing. I don't think that's being narcissistic. That's you being confident about yourself. But when you're putting other people down to lift yourself up, to make yourself look better, then that's definitely more narcissistic than it is you having that internal and external confidence.
Yes.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
So what are some things, what are some signs, like, if I scroll through social media right now, if I go on IG right now, if I go on Facebook right now, and I just scroll, what are some things that we should look for in spotting narcissists on social media?
That's an interesting question because I can only give... like my perspective of what I really believe.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think we can diagnose that by looking on social media. I'm just being honest.
No, well, I'm talking about not necessarily the disorder, because there's a narcissistic personality disorder in the DSM-5, and you have to meet certain criteria for that, for any diagnosis. But just someone that may be exhibiting narcissistic behavior.
Okay, well, let me just say this.
Mm-hmm.
We want to think that there aren't, but I have witnessed firsthand there are actually people on Instagram that talk about themselves in a grandiose way.
Wow.
And they look...
Third person?
I'm not going to say that. I was going to say they look very average. No, I don't want to say that. But all we can see is what... all we can go off with what we see.
Right.
Yeah. They talk in third person, okay? Mm-hmm. Which automatically, they put themselves up here when they refer to themselves in third person. And then it's not about how they come off as far as being average. It's... and just the average person, that's what I mean, okay? But it's the way they carry themselves on their page, like in videos. I'm not talking about photos, right? I'm actually talking about videos where people are talking, where women are looking into the camera saying, oh, and I am just, and blah, blah, blah. And if you want to learn how to be more like me, and people are saying these things.
Right.
I don't think anything like that when I post things. I'm just being me, and you can accept it for what it is and give it or take it. But yeah, people actually trying to convince and selling themselves almost like it's a product.
Yeah.
Okay.
So one thing, now just stumbled upon this right here, you guys. Like, this is
I see.
It's crazy. But you're going to find yourself looking after this live, after this show, you guys are going to look at
photos.
You're going to start looking at photos when I say this right here. But one of the characteristics or the way to spot someone that may be a narcissist on social media, on your timeline, is distinct eyebrows.
Okay, tell us about the eyebrows.
So I'm reading here and it says that, you know, surprisingly, they found that the eyebrows are the key to accurately detecting narcissism. So it's kind of like just the different facial features and where they raise their eyebrows and how they take their pictures. But narcissists may use their eyebrows to stand out or to look more attractive. And other researchers say that narcissists may naturally have more distinct eyebrows. So they may naturally just have them, and it kind of just, you know, like, oh, like she has some banging ass eyebrows. But look at people's eyebrows, and if it's like always going up a little bit, you know, you get that little smize going on, you know, things like that. Use of thick, yeah, that right there. That right there. Exactly. You see that? You see that arch right there? That right there.
I'm making it do that.
But that's what it is.
Okay.
That's what it is. That's very funny. That was very interesting. That they said that researchers said that people with distinct or attractive looking eyebrows tend to be more narcissistic. So if you got some banging eyebrows, I don't even want to talk to you.
Let's see what this person.
And also another characteristic is that you get fewer likes.
You're right. And, eyebrows.
You get fewer likes and comments from your actual friends on social media.
Because they don't really like you.
We know you in real life. That is not you. Well, it may be you.
This person that, you know, I told you about.
Okay.
Okay. That I, you know, experienced the narcissistic behavior.
Uh-huh.
I also at times was friends with the spouses of their friends.
Mm-hmm.
And the spouses would tell me that those friends were not really supportive of behaviors that this person had, right? So it's not that they weren't their true friend,
right?
But behind the scene, they don't tell that person what they're really thinking,
right?
Because that person's idea of their self is so grandiose. Exactly. They don't want to approach them about it. They just take the hands-off approach.
And they tend to have those friends that may consider themselves less than or may have a lower self-esteem. So like being in their company, sometimes they may have benefits. They may be able to get VIP or, you know, take trips and things like that. So you're like, cool.
Yeah.
Like I can, you know, hang with him. I don't like his attitude or the way that he treats people. But, you know, if we can.
Marlis, I have to read it. Marlis said, I love drawn-on eyebrows. Uh-huh. I've never heard anybody put things the way you put them. I love this. It lets me know a woman is a go-getter and willing to create her own opportunities even in the midst of her trials and tribulations.
No, go ahead. I'm sorry.
No, it was funny. I'm laughing at Marlis.
Yeah, like,
I know he means it.
They don't know people in real life.
Yeah.
Like,
they don't like you in real life.
It's a guy that I've known since like high school. Guy grew up kind of like middle class. Parents were okay. Wasn't rich or anything like that, but okay. And I recently accepted him on social media as a friend. And I just scrolled through his timeline and he's flashing money. Like maybe like 10 stacks.
I thought you were going to say $10.
No, like okay. 10 stacks. 10 whatever.
Stacks, okay.
You know, sitting on a car that's not his. Got on a fur that's not his.
Oh, he posted up like Frank Lucas.
Yeah, like, but it's always about money. It's always about his ego and what he can get, what he's experienced. You know, all those things. He would definitely be a narcissist.
Okay.
Because most of the time they're overcompensating for something that they're lacking.
Of course.
You know, there's usually something that's going on within them emotionally that they have to overcompensate to be this grandiose type of person. you know. Yep. Another one is an attention seeking profile pic, you know, like your page like that.
Yep.
You get people, and you know, you on Facebook you get those suggested friends, and on IG you get those suggested friends, and it's just pow. You're like, oh snap! Like, let me send a request. Let me follow this person right here. So it's gravitating, you know, people towards you just with your profile pic.
And it's obvious that you created that, though.
Right.
Like, it's obvious that you were seeking attention.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We're not just talking about people smiling.
Right.
And that being attractive.
No. Or looking like a snack on your profile.
Some people can't help looking like a snack unless you're talking about showing, like,
yeah, like skin just a little bit of extra. They did a Lizzo. You know, just bing.
You know what I noticed? Listen.
Side note. That was a big thong.
I almost choked on my... I almost... clutched the pearls.
Is it not supposed to disappear?
Almost. Okay.
Is it not supposed to... Well, maybe because she was like bent down.
Oh,
but
my goodness.
I thought it was supposed to disappear. I mean, I'm the thong. It's supposed to... But...
I saw the cheeks, and once I saw that, I immediately X'd off that photo. I was going to say that I've noticed that people use raunchy profile pictures that aren't even them. Like, I see a lot of men having women as their profile picture, like women's bodies.
What?
Like, yeah, I've seen that. Yeah. Because some of you are adding me as a friend. Don't even do that.
And you thinking it's a female?
I'm thinking it's a female, and then I see the name, and I see it's like Gerard. And I'm like, Gerard! Why are you using a picture of some girl's butt as your profile? Yeah, they do that. And then they... Gerard. I'm just throwing out that name because it's a boy name. But yeah.
Absolutely. Gerard.
Yeah, I see men putting women in their stories too. Like half-naked women. Haven't you seen that? In their stories like, damn, and blah, blah. Like to get attention and somebody to comment on it. And I don't look at it as narcissistic, but it's attention-grabbing.
Yeah,
it's ways that you ploy for attention.
Right.
That's everywhere on social media.
And even just in your day-to-day, like, you're always, like, dressed to impress. Always. There's never really a baggy jogging pants and a t-shirt to go to Walmart. You got to be dressed to the T. You got to have on your gaiters. You got to have on, like, this club outfit or something very provocative.
Do you think that's narcissistic or is it just extreme tension-seeking due to low self-esteem and insecurities?
But these are some things that could be.
Okay. They're potential signs.
Yeah, we're talking about
social
media.
Okay, we're not diagnosing
like,
strangers walking out the street.
Right.
Okay.
No, we're not doing that.
Potential.
But it's more so like why are you doing that? Why are you in food line with like 6-inch heels and you about to go home? Like, why?
Never mind. Don't get me started. This is Charlotte. Charlotte,
right.
I'm saying Charlotte people act like they don't know how to dress down. Sometimes our Charlotte women dress for prom at the bar. And I'm like, look, wear your wedge sneakers and your ones. Why we gotta wear 4-inch heels everywhere? This is Time Warner Cable Arena. You walked 4 blocks from the car. Why are you wearing 5-inch stiletto heels? You know it's true.
Yeah.
It's happens. That attention seeking. I mean, come on. So anyway.
So how would you know? So how would you know? Yeah, we're about to wrap this thing up. We're at 6 o'clock. But you know how we do it. So, again, like in relationships, because we really haven't touched on relationships and how to recognize whether your partner is a narcissist. How would that like come across in just intimate and romantic relationships?
Okay, let me say, number one, they frequently threaten you.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so if they're frequently, let me tell y'all what happened to me. There were times that I didn't make a bed and the comment was, you know there are women dying to come in here and make my bed.
That's a great example.
Yeah. Yep. And I, listen, y'all.
What you
I was young.
Do, the other person will.
I was young and I had my feelings attached to this person.
Right.
So
right.
I told myself, like, I gave myself some excuses, you know, like, he's just playing, but that's not nice.
Right.
And then by the third time I heard it, and it wasn't all the time, but by the third time I heard it, I'm like, wait a minute. This isn't good. Like, this isn't... There's no going up from this.
Right.
It was really hard, okay? And I stayed in that for years. I was. But I was a complete empath.
Right.
I was feeding that all the time. Like, okay, what do you mean? All right, I'll start making the bed eventually. So
yeah, like, what do I need to do?
I wasn't looking at it that I shouldn't be threatened.
Right.
And I should just walk. I was like, all right, how do I make this work? Like, it's my fault.
Mm.
Yep. Yeah, so they frequently threaten you.
And always make it about you. It's your fault.
Yeah, it was my fault. Everything is my fault.
Right.
They make you feel guilty.
Uh-huh.
And they dig up the dirt. So that's what to look for. What we talked about before, they dig up the dirt on you and remind you of things.
Right.
To induce the guilt.
Mm. Now, one could be, I just lost it. It's going to come back to me. But they make it about themselves, but again, it's always your fault. We said that they threaten you.
Mm-hmm.
But this is what it was. This is a big one, you guys. And don't mistake this for reciprocity. They do things to get you in. Like, they'll purchase you things. You'd be like, oh my goodness, like, he's bought me flowers, mm-hmm. and he's taking me on trips, and he's doing all these
lavish things. Yeah. Treat you lavishly. Exactly. It doesn't have to be just with things, but
then throw it in your face. Be like, I did this for you. I would never do this for anyone else, and I did it for
you. Yeah, and that builds themselves up.
Right.
They're building themselves up to you.
Right.
This is how, dang, somebody was telling me, you know, they were referring to themselves as like a chosen person.
Mm.
Literally using that word.
Wow.
Chosen.
Mm.
And so these things are real, you know, that people, if you just listen to people, if they talk long enough, you just listen long enough, you will catch those things and say, you know what? We was listening to that narcissism show, and there's too much of this here. So
y'all are really going to be listening.
Yeah,
to
yeah, because
now.
I'm like, thinking seriously. About it even as we're talking,
right.
And that
right.
shit is real. I mean, I lived that,
yeah.
and it
yeah.
does happen.
Absolutely.
And people say those things. You just have to let them talk long enough, but they'll tell you what you want to know. They'll have certain tattoos on them, like chosen one, and all
really?
Kind of stuff like that. Yeah, people have stuff like that. And you
they
get
do.
Into a conversation about it. Oh, I believe that I have that God's taking care of me. Oh, I don't have to wear a seatbelt. I'm not going to die this way. You know how many times I've heard that? I'm like, really? You know how you're going to die?
I'm just going to be
like... No, because they believe this grandiose sense of self and self-worth and what their life is worth versus
Absolutely.
Somebody else, right? I've got this relationship with God. He's not going to let me go this way.
It
you know,
happens.
Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah, they say stuff like that.
So definitely, like, look at some information. We'll post some things on the platform to look out for, some characteristics. Do your own review. Look within yourself. Do some self-reflection. Because you may be a narcissist.
You know what? They also don't want you close to everyone in their social circle.
Oh, yeah.
Okay? Because they want the lies that they're telling...
To stick. Yes.
So if you're
absolutely.
Close to their friends and family,
mm-hmm.
you know, you can expose their lies.
Right.
And they don't want you to have those relationships.
Yeah.
Look for that.
That's a big one.
Okay. Look for
that's
that, y'all.
So when they don't introduce you to their friends and their family, and they just want to keep you to the side over here.
Mm-hmm. They don't want to introduce you. They're making you feel guilty.
Yeah.
They're chosen. You ain't shit. They chosen though. You ain't shit. And they with you. Then they're looking at you as an empath and somebody who can feed them.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yes.
But that is very manipulative. Very manipulative. So, you know, don't go out here diagnosing people, because I don't even diagnose that many people with personality disorders. I try to stay away from that. If I can.
Okay.
Now, after I've known that client for some time, we may go into personality disorders, but my initial session with that client, I'm not diagnosing them with a personality.
No,
disorder.
No.
But, and that's for
not
all my clinicians out there as well.
All the symptoms on the checklist. And then I was stray the other way.
But like and the reason being because that kind of sticks.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Yes,
because there's no true, one, there's no medication for it. For a personality disorder. There's no medication for a personality disorder.
Yeah.
You got borderline or narcissistic personality disorder or dissociative personality. Oh, there's no medication for that. There's extreme treatment, you know, treatment modalities and all that, but you can't take a Xanax if you got narcissistic.
I want to, you know, and I know we laughing about it, but seriously.
Yeah.
Somebody in my family called me selfish and narcissistic recently. Mm. And I was so offended, not by the selfish part, by the narcissistic part.
Why?
Well, because that's not true. And we dish out stuff too easily.
Right.
Okay, because narcissism is really severe.
Yeah.
And I have my self-centered and self-focused moments. A lot of it has to do with the amount of years I spent
not
focusing on myself. Mm-hmm. And now I'm somewhat overly focused on what I need. So I own that completely, but self-centered at times and focus on self and pulling myself out of situations to be mindful of what I need is not the same as being narcissistic, manipulative, pulling people apart from what real is in order to show them fake. Like that stuff is real. Like stop calling people narcissistic. Like just really go through that, the education of that.
It's gonna shut down on me.
Okay.
In a minute. Yeah. But anyway, on IG,
I just wanted to say that.
We'll follow up with you guys. Make sure you check it out. But anyway, one's about to end. Yeah.
Okay, we're over time, so we should talk about what's coming up, I guess.
Yeah, what's coming up? What you got going on?
Well, December 19th, next Thursday at 7:45 a.m., we are having the second episode of Getting Results for Your Mental Health on Fox 46 with Jason Harper. So I'm excited about it.
What's up, Jason?
What's up, Jason Harper?
He follows me. I follow him.
I know.
We're
followers. We're a following.
What's up, Jason? He's really cool.
Yeah, no, he is. He's really great. Cool. So he's supportive of the couch. So
Absolutely.
Yeah, he definitely is. So I'm excited about that. Just bringing mental health awareness to the forefront again at 7:45 in the morning. Will you be watching?
Yes. Not live, though.
All right, thanks for...
Yeah.
Okay, I'll send you the link.
Yeah, just send me the... They had it on like really quick last time.
I know. They have it on within an hour.
Yeah. I was like, wow. So, yeah. I just go to the website.
There's your narcissistic friend again on Instagram.
Yeah. There's a lot of narcissism going on Instagram. You follow these women, these Instagram models. It's a lot of it.
That picture was like... And she had her butt out and like her whole back.
Yeah.
I saw her before we started.
She was a fitness model.
She's a fitness model.
Yes.
Model.
Yeah, quote unquote.
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
She's an Instagram fitness model.
She might follow me on Facebook, but.
Did you say you hope?
No, I said she might.
I thought you said you hope she might follow you. Like you slipped. Did that slip out? I hope she might follow me.
No, like that particular body style isn't. No, attractive to me. Like if you're more muscular than me, I probably don't want to date you. So it's okay.
Truth.
Right.
Yeah, I feel you.
It is what it is.
Like, I don't want to be more muscular than curves, the man I'm dating either.
But not no hard curves.
See, this isn't a Hot Wheels track.
Yeah. I need something that's gonna bounce back a little bit. Not something that's gonna go. It's gonna shake a little bit, like after you hit it. Anyway, that's a different story for a different time, you guys. Different time, but make sure y'all handle that. But anyway, we got something coming up. Do you want to unveil that? Do you want to talk about that today?
No, we'll talk about that next week when we have details finalized. We have something coming up in the month of February.
Yes.
Okay. A live event.
Live event.
Okay.
The month of February.
I believe it's the 22nd. We can say.
Yes. It's going to be right around that time. Mm-hmm. It's going to be after Valentine's Day.
And it's not All-Star Weekend, and it's not Super Bowl Weekend.
Right.
So don't come at us with that.
Right.
So y'all should be there. We want y'all there.
Yeah, we want y'all there. We had a live last time, live band, had poets come through, bless the stage. So we're definitely going to have a little bit of that going on. It's going to be a fun time.
It's going to be a little bit
good
of
good networking. You know, we got a lot of clinicians that follow us here on the couch, a lot of fans and people who actually enjoy the show. So come out, show some support, have some fun, meet your favorite people that you see commenting here on the couch. And
we want to meet you.
Yeah, absolutely.
I love meeting people that watch the show. Y'all are the best.
You meet my family.
The family is the best.
Yes,
man. Everybody.
Everybody's family. So we come in there, have a good time with some music, some spirits going around, you know.
All kinds.
Yeah, we never...
We're not limiting.
Yeah, we never claim to be these, you know, square. We don't drink at all. Never.
We don't really know what's in this.
You just never know.
Judging by how many times I fall out of my chair during an episode. Now you'll have to wonder what's in.
No, yeah, no. We would never participate if we're too intoxicated. I'm just going to keep it real. We'll be like, we'll catch y'all next week.
The show's over.
Right, the show's over. But nah, seriously, but she may have something that can, you guys.
This was a good show. Yeah. This was necessary.
Yes, it was necessary, and mm-hmm. I wish we could expound on it more, but it's so many ins
maybe
and outs.
Some other time we could do part 2 and have somebody on here.
Yeah, I would love... Like, if you're a narcissist and you've been diagnosed with narcissistic personality disorder, like...
No, they'll take over our show.
No, shoot us an inbox.
So we can see how bad you are. Before we invite your ass on our show.
They'll have a whole bio.
Because I can't sit here with...
They will have a whole bio.
I can't sit here and compete with a narcissist on our own show.
No, but we will allow the world to see what a narcissist
is. Okay, fine. Because I was going to say, you know they're going to go against everything we say. Like, okay, I hear you.
Right.
So actually, I looked this up on Wikipedia.
That would be fun. That would be really fun.
I looked this up on Wikipedia, and I think you're wrong. I know you have degrees. I know you have a license. It doesn't matter. I've seen a few therapists myself. Mm. That's how they talk. They think they're the expert on everything.
Yeah.
Come on now.
Yeah. I looked you up. I know what it takes to become what you are, and I could definitely do that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that type of thing.
Yes, sir.
Or don't try to use that therapy stuff with me. It won't work.
I don't need to go to therapy, but if that's something you need to do to fix yourself,
right.
I totally support that. But I'm not going to see no therapist.
Right.
You know what that means? AKA, I don't have no damn problem. And you don't make the bed enough.
You're the problem.
So, you don't make the bed. So I'm going to get somebody else in the bed. Now you go to therapy.
Right. Just go.
Told me he could get somebody else to make the bed. In retrospect, I'm like, damn, I wish I was more mature at that time.
Mm.
Yeah, man. Sucked the life out of me.
Whew. Well, I'm glad you were able to overcome
that.
Yeah,
sure. Me too.
And you become the Jackie that we all know and love.
Thank you, Damien. That's nice for you to say.
Absolutely.
Just more secure.
But you guys, I mean, it's been great. It's been dope. Mm-hmm. As always, every week. Yeah. So, next week, we still got next week. One more week before the holiday break.
We have a guest next week.
Yes,
we push that guest to next week. It's going to be a very good show.
Very good show. Y'all stay tuned.
Mm-hmm.
We'll unveil that in the upcoming days, probably around Sunday. Sunday, Monday, you'll know what the topic and the guest is.
Just to give you an idea to know for next week, I think parents of school-age kids need to be watching specifically. Yes, school age kids, so elementary, middle, and high school,
right?
For sure. Okay,
the parents.
Yep, the parents.
And maybe kids can be,
I think the kids too.
Yeah,
this is gonna be a good one.
Yeah,
and we'll just make sure we keep our language
and spirits to the
side. And we know it's a family show, so next week it's a family show.
It's a family show, so don't cut your butt out.
It's going to be
because you can only see the top. You can't really see the bottom. So Jackie actually walked in here with a butt cut out. And said that she was going to put it on there. Y'all know I'm lying because she's already got up one time and tried to twerk. So y'all know I'm lying. It is what it is.
I love that you said tried. The jabs just keep coming. I did not try to. I did not. You're embarrassing me. The families can watch next week. Next week is a family show.
Yeah,
okay?
Absolutely.
We're going to be talking about an important topic.
Right. So we're going to be on our best behavior. When we have guests in, we try to be on our best behavior until the end of the show.
Like the commissioner until he mentioned the porn show. He was like, oh, you're not talking about porn this week? I was like, who told you that?
I looked at it.
Oh, I saw part of it. Oh, you did?
Yeah,
because I remember I had my good satin collar shirt on when he came.
No.
My good professional.
Commissioners watch porn too. They do.
Everybody watches. Well,
not everybody, but majority.
Well,
of people.
A lot of people do.
But if you make your own porn, it's all good. See, there you go. That twerk in that face. You see that eyebrow right there, you guys? You see that eyebrow? Do you see that eyrow right there?
I'm doing that on purpose.
About.
Whatever.
That's what we're talking about right now.
Somebody's hitting your hotline.
I get messages all the time, but...
Oh, that hotline. Quran used to say, when he was a toddler, he'd be like, when that hotline bling, when that hotline bling, mommy, when that hotline bling. Hell, you know about a hotline bling. I'm a bling your damn
life. Right.
Bling, he was like 4 years old.
Right.
Bling your damn.
That's all he knows.
Yeah. Anyway. All right.
All right, you guys. We're going to check y'all next week. Check out.
Share this episode.
Share it.
Like it.
Like it.
Flip it. Slap it.
Run it down.
That's the cootie roll.
With the cootie roll.
With the cootie roll.
But definitely go to the website, cal704.com. You know, check out all the updates on there.
Mm-hmm.
Anything we got upcoming, we try to post it on there as well. Check out the store. You know, get your couch official apparel online. Go mm-hmm. to the store. What else we got going on? Check out all social media platforms, IG, Facebook, Twitter, Snapchat. I haven't used a Snapchat. We just have one.
Yeah.
The Couch 704.
I don't really use Snapchat.
So if you need to send us a snap, like, just
send
go ahead and
send us a snap.
Send us a snap.
Also, we want show ideas.
Yeah.
What
like
you guys want to see?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay,
if
send
you
us messages.
Ideas, DM. Send us mm-hmm. a DM or an email. Like, if you got an idea or something like that. Because, I mean, we can go on for days. Like,
yep.
I don't think we've really repeated any
We've
topics.
Never repeated a topic yeah. unless we just enhanced the conversation
right.
about it.
Right. So, we always got fresh ideas. We always welcome fresh ideas to the show and how to make it better. So please send your comments, your suggestions. We'll definitely, you know, value that feedback for sure.
Okay.
All right, you guys. We'll check y'all next week. Same bad time, same bad channel. I'm your host, Dane. As always, my co-host,
Juicy J.
Juicy is in the building. And we out of here. Peace. Your mental health matters.